Daily morning prayer, Monday, April 22nd, 2024. If then you have been raised with Christ, seek the things that are above, where Christ is, seated at the right hand of God. Let us humbly confess our sins to Almighty God. Almighty and most merciful Father, we have erred and strayed from your ways, lost sheep. We have followed too much the devices and desires of our own hearts. We have offended against your holy laws. We have left undone those things which we ought to have done, and we have done those things which we ought not to have done. And apart from your grace, there is no health in us. O Lord, have mercy upon us. Spare all those who confess their faults. Restore all those who are penitent, according to your promises declared to all people in Christ Jesus our Lord. And grant, O most merciful Father, for his sake, that we may now live a godly, righteous, and sober life, to the glory of your holy name. Amen. Grant your faithful people, merciful Lord, pardon and peace, that we may be cleansed from all our sins, and serve you with a quiet mind. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. O Lord, open our lips, and our mouth shall proclaim your praise. O God, make speed to save us. O Lord, make haste to help us. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. Praise the Lord. The Lord's name be praised. Alleluia. The Lord has risen indeed. O come, let us adore him. O come, let us sing unto the Lord. Let us heartily rejoice in the strength of our salvation. Let us come before his presence with thanksgiving, and show ourselves glad in him with psalms. For the Lord is a great God, and a great King above all gods. In his hand are all the depths of the earth, and the heights of the hills are his also. The sea is his, for he made it, and his hands prepared the dry land. O come, let us worship and fall down and kneel before the Lord our Maker, for he is our God, and we are the people of his pasture, and the sheep of his hand. Today, if you will hear his voice, harden not your hearts, as in the provocation, and as in the day of temptation in the wilderness. When your fathers tested me and put me to the proof, though they had seen my works, 40 years long was I grieved to this generation. It is a people that err in their hearts, for they have not known my ways, of whom I swore in my wrath, that they should not enter into my rest. Alleluia, the Lord is risen indeed. O come, let us adore him. O give thanks unto the Lord, for he is gracious, and his mercy endures forever. Let those whom the Lord has redeemed give thanks, whom he has delivered from the hand of the enemy, and gathered them out of the lands, from the east and from the west, and from the north and from the south. They went astray in the wilderness, even in the desert, and found no city to dwell in. They were hungry and thirsty, and their soul fainted within them. Then they cried unto the Lord in their trouble, and he delivered them from their distress. He led them forth by a straight path, until they came to a city where they might dwell. Oh, that they would therefore praise the Lord for his goodness, and declare the wonders that he does for the children of men. For he satisfies the empty soul, and fills the hungry soul with goodness. Some sat in darkness and in the shadow of death, being bound fast in misery and iron. because they rebelled against the words of God and lightly regarded the counsel of the Most High. He also brought down their heart with heaviness. They fell down and there was none to help them. Then they cried unto the Lord in their trouble, and he delivered them out of their distress. For he brought them out of darkness and out of the shadow of death and broke their bones asunder. Oh, that they would therefore praise the Lord for his goodness and declare the wonders that he does for the children of men. For he has broken the gates of brass and shattered the bars of iron asunder. The foolish were plagued for their offense, and because of their wickedness, their soul abhorred all manner of food, and they were even close to death's door. So when they cried unto the Lord in their trouble, he delivered them out of their distress. He sent his word and healed them, and they were saved from destruction. Oh, that they would therefore praise the Lord for his goodness and declare the wonders that he does for the children of men. That they would offer unto him the sacrifice of thanksgiving and tell of his works with gladness. Those who go down to the sea in ships, who carry out their business in great waters, they behold the works of the Lord and his wonders in the deep. For at his word the stormy wind arises, which lifts up the waves. They are carried up to heaven and down again to the deep. Their soul melts away because of the trouble. They reel to and fro and stagger like a drunken man and are at their wits' end. So when they cry unto the Lord in their trouble, he delivers them out of their distress. For he makes the storm to cease so that the waves are still. And they are glad because they are at rest. And so he brings them into the haven where they desire to be. Oh, that they would therefore praise the Lord for his goodness and declare the wonders that he does for the children of men. That they would exalt him also in the congregation of the people and praise him in the seat of the elders. He turns rivers into a wilderness and water springs into thirsty ground. A fruitful land he makes barren because of the wickedness of those who dwell there. Again, he makes the wilderness into pools of water and dry ground into water springs. And there he sets the hungry that they may build a city to dwell in. That they may sow their land and plant vineyards to yield the fruits of increase. He blesses them so that they multiply exceedingly and does not allow their cattle to decrease. And again, when they are diminished and brought low through oppression, through any plague or trouble, though he pours contempt on princes and lets them wander in pathless wilderness, yet he helps the poor out of misery and increases their households like a flock of sheep. The righteous will consider this and rejoice, and the mouth of all wickedness shall be stopped. Whoever is wise will ponder these things and shall understand the loving kindness of the Lord. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. A reading from the book of Numbers, beginning with the 18th chapter, the first verse. So the Lord said to Aaron, "You, your sons, and your father's household with you shall bear the guilt in connection with the sanctuary, and you and your sons with you shall bear the guilt in connection with your priesthood. But also bring your brothers with you, the tribe of Levi, the tribe of your father, so that they may join you and serve you, while you and your sons with you are before the tent of the testimony. And they shall perform duties for you and the duties of the whole tent, but they shall not come near the furnishings of the sanctuary and the altar, or both they and you will die. They shall join you and perform the duties of the tent of meeting for all the service of the tent. But an unauthorized person shall not come near you. So you shall perform the duties of the sanctuary and the duties of the altar so that there will be no longer, so that there will no longer be wrath on the sons of Israel. Behold, I myself have taken your fellow Levites from among the sons of Israel. They are a gift to you, dedicated to the Lord, to perform the service for the tent of meeting. But you and your sons with you shall attend to your priesthood for everything that concerns the altar and inside the veil, and you are to perform service. I am giving you the priesthood as a service that is a gift, and the unauthorized person who comes near shall be put to death. Then the Lord spoke to Aaron, "Now behold, I myself have put you in charge of my offerings. All the holy gifts of the sons of Israel I have given to you as a portion and to your sons as a permanent allotment. This shall be yours from the most holy gifts reserved from the fire. Every offering of theirs, namely every grain offering, every sin offering, every guilt offering, with which they shall make restitution to me, shall be most holy for you and for your sons. As the most holy gifts, you shall eat it. Every male shall eat it. It shall be holy to you. This also is yours, the offering of their gift. That is, all the wave offerings of the sons of Israel. I have given them to you and to your sons and daughters with you as a permanent allotment. Everyone of your household who is clean may eat it, all the best of the fresh oil, and all the best of the fresh wine, and all the grain, the first fruits of what they give to the Lord. I have given them to you, the first ripe fruits of all that is in their land, which they bring to the Lord, shall be yours. Every one of your household who is clean may eat it. Everything banned from secular use in Israel shall be used. Every firstborn of the womb of all flesh, whether human or animal, which they offer to the Lord, shall be yours. However, you must redeem the human firstborn, and the firstborn of unclean animals you shall redeem. As to their redemption price from a month old, you shall redeem them by your assessment, 5 shekels in silver by the shekel of the sanctuary, which is 20 gerahs. But the firstborn of an ox, the firstborn of a sheep, and the firstborn of a goat, you shall not redeem. They are holy. You shall sprinkle their blood on the altar and offer up their fat in smoke as an offering by fire for a smoothing aroma to the Lord. However, their meat shall be yours. It shall be yours like the breast of a wave offering and like the right thigh. All the offerings of the holy gifts which the sons of Israel offer to the Lord, I have given to you and your sons and your daughters with you as a permanent allotment. It is a permanent covenant of salt before the Lord to you and your descendants with you. Then the Lord said to Aaron, "You shall have no inheritance in their land, nor own any portion among them. I am your portion and your inheritance among the sons of Israel." To the sons of Levi, behold, I have given all the tithe in Israel as an inheritance in return for their service which they perform, the service of the tent of meeting. And the sons of Israel shall not come near the tent of meeting again, for they will bring sin on themselves and die. Only the Levites shall perform the service of the tent of meeting, and they shall bear their own guilt. It shall be a permanent statute throughout your generations, and among the sons of Israel they shall have no inheritance. For the tithe of the sons of Israel, which they offer as an offering to the Lord, I have given to the Levites as an inheritance. Therefore I have said concerning them, they shall have no inheritance among the sons of Israel. Then the Lord spoke to Moses, saying, Moreover, you shall speak to the Levites and say to them, When you take from the sons of Israel the tithe which I have given for you, which I have given you from them for your inheritance, then you shall present an offering from it to the Lord, a tithe of the tithe. Your offering shall be credited to you like the grain from the threshing floor, or the full price, or for the full produce from the wine vat. So you shall also present an offering to the Lord from all your tithes, which you receive from the sons of Israel, and from it you shall give the Lord's offering to Aaron the priest. Out of all your gifts you shall present every offering due to the Lord, from all the best of them, the sacred part from them. And you shall say to them, when you have offered from it the best of it, then when you have offered from it the best of it, then the rest shall be credited to the Levites, like the product of the threshing floor, and like the product of the wine vat. You may eat it anywhere, you and your households, for it is your compensation in return for your service in the tent of meeting. And you will bring on yourselves no sin by reason of it when you have offered the best of it. But you shall not profane the sacred gifts of the sons of Israel, so that you do not die. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Surely it is God who saves me. I will trust in him and not be afraid, for the Lord is my stronghold and my sure defense, and he will be my savior. Therefore you shall draw water with rejoicing from the springs of salvation, and on that day you shall say, Give thanks to the Lord, and call upon his name. Make his deeds known among the people, see that they remember that his name is exalted. Sing the praises of the Lord, for he has done great things, and this is known in all the world. Cry aloud, inhabitants of Zion, ring out your joy. For the Great One, in the midst of you, is the Holy One of Israel. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. A reading from the Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to St. Mark, beginning with the 14th chapter, the first verse. Now the Passover and festival of unleavened bread were 2 days away, and the chief priests and scribes were seeking how to arrest him covertly and kill him. But they were saying, not during the festival, otherwise there will be a riot of the people. While he was in Bethany at the home of Simon the leper, he was reclining at the table, and a woman came with an alabaster vial of very expensive perfume of pure nard. She broke the vial and poured the perfume over his head, but there were some indignantly. But there was some indignantly remarking to one another, Why has this perfume been wasted? For this perfume could have been sold for over 300 denarii, and the money given to the poor. And they were scolding her. But Jesus said, Leave her alone. Why are you bothering her? She has done a good deed for me. For you always have the poor with you, and wherever and whenever you want, you can do good to them. But you do not always have me. She has done what she could. She has anointed my body beforehand for the burial. Truly I say to you, wherever the gospel is preached in the entire world, what this woman has done will also be told in memory of her. And Judas Iscariot, who was one of the 12, went off to the chief priests in order to betray him to them. They were delighted when they heard this and promised to give him money, and he began seeking how to betray him at an opportune time. On the first day of unleavened bread, when the Passover lamb was being sacrificed, his disciples said to him, "Where do you want us to go and prepare for you to eat Passover?" And he sent two of his disciples and said to them, "Go into the city, and a man carrying a pitcher of water will meet you. Follow him. And wherever he enters, say to the owner of the house, 'The teacher says, where is my guest room, in which I may eat the Passover with my disciples?' And he himself will show you a large upstairs room furnished and ready. Prepare for us there." The disciples left and came to the city and found everything just as he had told them. And they prepared the Passover. When it was evening, he came to the 12, and as they were reclining at the table and eating, Jesus said, "Truly I say to you that one of you will betray me, one who is eating with me." They began to be grieved and say to him one by one, "Surely not I." But he said to them, "It is one of the 12, the one who dips bread with me in the bowl. For the Son of Man is going away, just as it is written about him. But woe to that man by whom the Son of Man is betrayed. It would have been good for that man if he had not been born." While they were eating, he took some bread, and after a blessing, he broke it and gave it to them and said, "Take it, this is my body." And when he had taken a cup and given thanks, he gave it to them, and they all drank from it. And he said to them, "This is my blood of the covenant, which is being poured out for many. Truly I say to you, I will not drink of the fruit of the vine again until the day when I drink it new in the kingdom of God." This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. O ruler of the universe, Lord God, great deeds are they that you have done, surpassing human understanding. Your ways are ways of righteousness and truth, O King of all the ages. Who can fail to do you homage, Lord, and sing the praises of your name? For you only are the Holy One. All nations will draw near and fall down before you, because your just and holy works have been revealed. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. I believe in God, the Father, almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. The Lord be with you, and with your spirit. Let us pray. Lord, have mercy upon us. Christ, have mercy upon us. Lord, have mercy upon us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. O Lord, show your mercy upon us, and grant us your salvation. O Lord, guide those who govern us, and lead us in the way of justice and truth. Clothe your ministers with righteousness, and let your people sing with joy. O Lord, save your people, and bless your inheritance. Give peace in our time, O Lord, and defend us by your mighty power. Let not the needy, O Lord, be forgotten, nor the hope of the poor be taken away. Create in us clean hearts, O God, and take not your Holy Spirit from us. O God, whose Son, Jesus Christ, is the good shepherd of your people, grant that when they hear his voice, you may know him who calls us each by name and follow where he leads, who with you and the Holy Spirit lives and reigns, one God forever and ever. Amen. O God, the King eternal, whose light divides the day from the night and turns the shadow of death into the morning, drive far from us all wrong desires, incline our hearts to keep your law, and guide our feet into the way of peace, that having done your will with cheerfulness during the day, we may, when night comes, rejoice to give you thanks. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. O God, you have made of one blood all the peoples of the earth, and sent your blessed Son to preach peace to those who are far off and to those who are near. Grant that people everywhere may seek after you and find you. Bring the nations into your fold. Pour out your Spirit upon all flesh, and hasten the coming of your kingdom. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Almighty God, Father of all mercies, we, your unworthy servants, give you humble thanks for your goodness and loving kindness to us and to all whom you have made. We bless you for our creation, preservation, and all the blessings of this life, but above all, for your immeasurable love and the redemption of the world by our Lord Jesus Christ, for the means of grace and for the hope of glory. And we pray, give us such an awareness of your mercies that with truly thankful hearts we may show forth your praise, not only with our lips, but in our lives, by giving up ourselves to your service and by walking before you in holiness and righteousness all our days. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, to whom with you and the Holy Spirit be honor and glory throughout all ages. Amen. Almighty God, you have given us grace at this time with one accord to make our common supplications to you, and you have promised through your well-beloved Son that when two or three are gathered together in his name, you will grant their requests. Fulfill now, O Lord, our desires and petitions as may be best for us, granting us in this world knowledge of your truth, and in the age to come, life everlasting. Amen. Alleluia, alleluia. Let us bless the Lord. Alleluia, alleluia. Thanks be to God. May the God of hope fill us with all joy and peace and believing through the power of the Holy Spirit. Amen.